is Word the Street with your host, Uncle Nick. I'm the bipolar, biracial bastard, the motherfucking lone wolf, the black Italian stallion. Uncle Nick is here to do motherfucking work, and if you don't know, you better ask somebody. The niggas, the bitches, the ladies, the gents, the rats, the cats, the motherfucking dogs, the babies, the aliens, the reptiles, the motherfucking reptilians. Ask them all. Uncle Nick is down for to come up in a New York minute, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Stop fucking playing with me. I'm Sicilian, but I'm not a square. You know what I mean? Bada bang, bada boom, boom, boom. Motherfuckers, let's get this shit popping. Shout out the Wolfpack, shout out everybody in the comment section, all the new subscribers, all the old subscribers, everybody hitting that motherfucking notification button, and most of all, everybody that donates to the motherfucking show, you know what I mean? Shout out to y'all motherfuckers. Drip, drip, drip fills the bucket, bitch. You know what time it is, you know what I mean? But without further ado, further delay, let's get into this motherfucking shit and let's get it poppin'. Let's go. Now, punk-ass DJ Academics and motherfucking Casanova are back at it again, bickering in the motherfucking public sector. And they've had some shit going on for a while now, you know what I mean? And I guess it's come to a boiling point because of the whole Tekashi 6ix9ine situation. They feel that DJ Academics is out here snitching, you know what I mean? And the shit that he does just isn't good for the culture, and he got motherfuckers lined up, and that's supposed to be his friend and all that fly shit. And it's not only Casanova, Joe Budden, Charlemagne, this one, that one. Everyone's had a little something to say. So this nigga DJ Academics got a little saucy last night, because he's a funny individual. I see that every time he does his live streams or whatever the fuck, he gets twisted to talk to the people to get that face on motherfucking camera, you know what I'm saying? I like to drink when I do my live streams, but it's just me cutting loose, you know what I'm saying? I had a long motherfucking week, but I think DJ Academics does that to fucking pump himself up. Like, yo, let me hit this Henny real fast and I can talk this shit to these people. Give them the truth, give them that dog shit, you know what I'm saying? Negative.com, you know what I mean? But DJ Academics was like, yo, why you mad at me, motherfucker, when Joe Budden is the nigga that instigated all of this? And I have to fucking agree with DJ Academics at the end of the day. Casanova went over there, sat on that show with fucking Joe Budden, was talking some high-powered shit, and everybody can say whatever the fuck they want to say. I see this weird shit going on where somebody's not supposed to have an opinion, or somebody can't tell someone, fuck you, or you're an ugly motherfucker, or I don't like your music, or whatever the fuck it is. Why do we all gotta be best friends and shit? One day I might be cool with you, the next day I'm like, man, fuck that shit, let's get it popping. There aren't fucking parameters to this, but there are parameters to this, you know what I'm saying? Your own personality, the way you get down, do what you want to do. But when you start putting other motherfuckers in predicaments where they're gonna start going to jail and shit, that's where you gotta pump your brakes. And that's the problem that I have with all these other YouTube channels and motherfuckers getting down like the beds, recording niggas and shit. But let's keep it motherfucking donkey. Fuck that shit. This nigga Joe Budden's got Casanova over there on the show. I don't know if they were drinking, whatever they were doing. I see this nigga smoking mad Newports and all that. Get it down for the come up. Niggas had some orange drink or whatever the fuck that was. But anyhow, you start this fucking beef with this kid Tekashi 6ix9ine. And I guess everybody thought he was a punk or he wasn't gonna respond, or maybe shoddy and these niggas made him respond. However the fuck it went down at the end of the day, this whole fucking beef gets started. They wind up running down on Casanova over there at some fucking concert or whatever was going on in New York City. Shotty and these niggas showed up, start tucking his jewelry, doing what he's doing, you know what I'm saying? Then they bump into each other again, I guess at the strip club, the shit gets squashed or whatever the fuck. So I guess Casanova feels like his hands are clean, he did the right thing, you know what I'm saying? And he could have smashed that kid, but he didn't, and yada, yada, yada. But at the end of the day, you started the fucking problem with the kid on Joe Budden's show. So how does this solely become DJ Academics' motherfucking problem when that's his fucking sidekick? They were over there doing everyday struggle. They were fucking holding it down, chummy, chummy, right? Nigga went to revolt. That nigga stayed there. It is what the fuck it is at the end of the day. But how does this nigga Joe button, get a motherfucking pass. That's the shit that's got me puzzled right now. And I don't like when niggas try to dogpile one motherfucker because he's the most popular individual. Or is that the motherfucking game plan? Everybody's gonna band together and everybody's gonna take a swipe at DJ Academics, you know what I'm saying? Try to knock down that stock a little bit. I don't fucking know. But what I do know is like two or three of those charges in that 17 count indictment, that RICO shit, are related to fucking Casanova, the Barclays shit, this or that, or whatever the fuck. And that shit is a direct correlation to the shit that got popped on fucking Joe Budden's show at the end of the day. So behind the scenes, is Casanova's wheels spinning right now? Like, holy shit, this punk ass nigga DJ Academics is posting all this extra shit at the end of the day. And am I gonna be called into this case? And am I gonna have to sit down for depositions, this, that, whatever the fuck, you know what I mean? Am I gonna have to prove my innocence, or am I gonna have to get on the stand and fight for this fucking kid? What are you getting me involved in, you punk ass motherfucker? He just got off parole and shit, so it makes sense that deep down inside he will be fucking more angry with DJ Academics than Joe Buttons, because Joe Buttons wasn't the one promoting those videos and pushing this and pushing that. At the end of the day, it was the other little nigga on the other side. And are they gonna wind up pulling DJ Academics in as well? I don't motherfucking know. Is everybody gonna start sitting down, having to cooperate with the feds? Not in a sense like they're snitching or something like that. Or they're gonna be facing legal ramifications and things like that, because these niggas didn't have anything to do with what Tekashi was doing to other motherfuckers. But are you gonna have to sit down and answer some fucking questions so they can get some context to your involvement in this and that, and what you do know, and why you posted this? What's going on behind the scenes, and what was this trip about? And all types of fucking shit related to Academics and other stuff related to Casanova. This is fucking ill right here. So it's Casanova, like, dunk down, I'm gonna knock this nigga's block off, because he just fucking does too much at the end of the day. But this is what you gotta start thinking about. You got all these other YouTube niggas, all these other motherfuckers that wanna post people's business, record shit, do this, do that. Is it gonna get to the point where other YouTubers and other motherfuckers like DJ Academics are gonna start getting pulled into these motherfucking cases with the feds and shit like that? Because they wanna know what time this went down, who was saying this. They're gonna wanna go through your motherfucking log, whatever the fuck is going on. You're gonna have to sit down and have some type of connection to these motherfuckers, because you chose to fucking get involved and put these different things out there like that. You know what I'm saying? Because you got evidence. If you just sit up here, speak your fucking piece, that nigga's getting his ass whooped, but this is going out, or somebody's stealing, or whatever the fuck, you know what I'm saying? Somebody's doing backflips with a tranny, whatever. The feds, they don't give a shit about that at the end of the day. But you over here posting hammers, this, that, you recreating fucking scenarios for people, and you got all the fucking videos. And you got all the little fucking digital footprints popping off with tags and comments and all that shit. Best believe they're gonna come talk to you one day too. So is this about to change the whole fucking playing field on YouTube and the way people look at creating content moving forward within motherfucking hip hop? That's what I wanna know. But this is some ill shit right here, you know what I'm saying? I think Casanova should be upset with Joe Budden more than anything, you know what I'm saying? But you got a lot of these motherfuckers, like I said, they're all to fucking blame. It just ain't DJ Academics, because you had a lot of niggas that mimicked his behavior. And then the public actually eats that shit up, and they love it, because they're nosy motherfuckers, and they're low down, they're dick riders. And just because somebody's popular, they're gonna fucking ride with that person, and they can be down with some old fuck shit, they can be doing all kind of stupid shit behind the scenes, but they won't care, because the masses say, oh, this person's popular, or you like the way they said this word, or the way they dress, or who they were connected to, so your dumbass is gonna go with the flow. And then all of a sudden, you start seeing that all these niggas that are pump fake, all the shit Uncle Nick was talking about 2 months ago is starting to come to fruition. And now they're like, hold on, who's this guy word the street, man? Maybe he fucking knows what he's talking about. But I was blacking out on niggas, I was upset and I was angry, and I didn't like the direction that I seen this shit going in. And now, booyah, look at what we motherfucking got, you understand? Look at what we're dealing with. I saw this shit coming. I didn't know how it was gonna go down, who it was gonna go down with, but I said, yo, this type of culture, this type of content, this type of bullshit right here is not gonna create nothing but a cesspool and a clusterfuck for the law enforcement, the feds, CIA, and everybody to just jump in and grab up all types of little intricate pieces of information about all types of shit and break down motherfucking hip-hop on a different level, you know what I'm saying? So then you only have Drake, you only have this, you only have that. I don't fucking know, maybe I'm ranting and raving, you know what I'm saying? We've reached a certain point within this hip-hop community on YouTube. I haven't been doing this shit that long, maybe about a year and a half now, 2 years approaching there, you know what I'm saying? I'm not like some nigga that been on YouTube for 8, 9, 10 years, 6, 7 years, doing whatever the fuck he's doing. But I'm in the fucking sector now, and this shit is starting to implode because you got a lot of hoe-ass niggas that became popular. But anyhow, y'all motherfuckers, let me know what y'all think in the comment section, you know what I'm saying? And if you appreciate the content, get up in the description box and drop a dome. Nation, you know what I'm saying? Drip, drip, drip fills the bucket. And other than that, I'm out this motherfucker. Y'all be safe, be cool, be easy. Don't do anything stupid on the fucking internet or in the streets. And I'll see y'all motherfuckers soon. Peace!